I am Dr. Venkanakanna Veena. I am working as assistant professor in St. Martin Engineering College, Sikindrabad, Telangana. Now I am going to explain about light emitting diode. Okay, we will see light emitting diode. Or you can say LED. So light emitting diode. So before going to the topic, how this is working, what are the application, first we will see applications. So nowadays we are seeing lots of applications depending on LEDs. We are using displays, railway signals, traffic signals, and computers, laptops, computers, and many systems and household bulbs. We are using these LEDs many places. Okay, these LEDs have lot of applications. Why these LEDs have lot of application means these are very cheap and lightweight, small in size, and also most importantly, it consumes very less power and also lifetime also very high. Okay, because of this tremendous advantages, we are using LEDs every many fields. Okay, so earlier in households we have incandescent bulbs that is used to go within a few very less time they used to burst. Okay, blown out. So these LEDs are these LEDs lifetime is very long. We can use like years, 1 year, 2 year, like that. Okay, the manufacturing company is also giving guarantee for this LED bulbs. Now we'll see what is the LED. Okay, so this is simple. So we'll discuss what is the LED and how it will work. It is a simple PN junction diode. Simple PN junction diode and diode, and it converts the electrical energy into optical energy. Electrical energy into optical energy. So it is simple PN junction diode and it converts the electrical energy into optical energy. Okay, optical energy. Optical energy when you connect this PN junction in forward bias condition. That is the LED of working of LED. It is simple PN junction diode and it converts the electrical energy into optical energy or electrical signal into optical signal when you connect this PN junction under forward bias condition. Now we will see how this is a simple formula, the main function of main use of this LED. Now we will see when you connect this PN junction, what happens, how it will work, we will see. Working principle of working of LED. Working. So, as we know, so when you, there is a, any, every semiconductor, there is a valence band and conduction band. Valence band and conduction band. When electrons jumps from conduction band to valence band, okay, they will recombine in the valence band. Electrons will recombine with holes in valence band. In this process, in this recombination process, photons will be emitted. Okay, excess energy emitted in the form of photons. Okay, this is what light means. Light is nothing, photons is we are calling light. Light is photons. Okay, so when electrons jumping from conduction band to valence band, these electrons will recombine with holes. In this recombination process, electron lost energy in the form of photons. That is what light means. Okay, photons, or you can say light. Okay, so now in PN junction diode, how these are working, we will see. Okay, now see, here see, when you combine P-type and N-type semiconductor, this is P-type and N-type semiconductor. Here P-type, we know, P-type, majority carrier, holes are the majority carriers, and N-type, electrons are the majority carriers. Okay, now when you combine this p-type and n-type semiconductor, here holes are the majority in p-type semiconductor and electrons are the majority in n-type semiconductor, right? So here also some electrons, this is the interface. Okay, when you combine these holes diffuse towards the p-n-type region and electrons diffuse towards the n-type region, while diffusing these holes leaves the negative ion density or negative ions here, or the here electrons leaves the positive ion here. This is what we are calling depletion region. What is the depletion region? Depletion region. So once this depletion region is formed, there is a electric field in the depletion region and also formation of potential barrier or potential height. So further these electrons wants to go here, they will see some potential height or potential barrier. So you need to give some extra energy to these electrons or holes to cross the barrier. So here when they come here in this process, the diffusion process, these electrons and holes will recombine at the interface or at the junction. These holes and electrons will recombine at the interface and they will emit the photons. So they will emit the photons here. Okay, this is the process. See, so in when they recombine, photons are emitted. So if you apply forward bias condition, more holes will diffuse towards the interface as well as more electrons diffuse towards the interface, so that more number of electrons holes come to the interface and they will recombine, so that we get more number of photons in forward bias condition, so that we are applying forward bias condition to this p-n junction diode. So in reverse bias condition, that is not useful condition for these LEDs, because electrons are attracted towards the negative positive potential and holes attracted to the negative potential. So that is not useful for condition for LEDs. So forward bias condition is very useful to improve the or increase the number of emitted photons here. Okay, now we are connecting some positive terminal to the p-type and negative terminal to the n-type semiconductor. So now this is the forward bias condition. What do you call this one? Forward bias condition. In forward bias condition, these holes are having positive charge and these holes were repelled by this positive terminal, and they will more holes diffuse towards the interface and also more electron diffuse towards the interface by negative potential. Okay, so that more number of electron holes will recombine at the interface, so that we'll get more number of photons in the p-n junction diode in forward bias condition. Okay, now see, we'll understand in the form of band bending diagram. Okay, so here I will draw a band bending diagram for p-type p-n junction in forward bias and reverse bias. So before drawing for forward bias condition, we'll draw the band diagram for equilibrium condition. That means we are not applying any biasing condition. Okay, so here this is the Fermi level. At equilibrium condition, the Fermi level is constant throughout the p-n junction. Okay, this is the Fermi level for p-type and n-type semiconductor. Here we are taking p-type and n-type. Okay, as we know, for p-type, Fermi level is close to the valence band. Okay, you just draw this one. Fermi level is close to the valence band and the conduction band is away from the valence band. Okay, this is valence band and this is conduction band. Okay, right. So here also, for n-type semiconductor, conduction band is close to the Fermi level and Fermi level are away from the valence band. Okay, this is EC and this is EV. Okay, right. Now the next work is to join these terminals. Okay, like this. Just you join these terminals and you got the band bending diagram of p-n junction. Okay, now you see here, at equilibrium position, the Fermi level is constant, and in the conduction band of n-type semiconductor, free holes are there. At the conduction band, valence band of p-type semiconductor, free holes are there. Okay, so this is the depletion region. We can say this is the depletion region, and free holes in valence band, free electrons in the conduction band. But our condition is we are applying forward bias condition for emit the more number of photons. So here we are connect the positive biasing. So before that, if you want to emit more number of photons, you have to increase the doping. If doping is increasing means, what is the doping before that? Suppose we are adding impurity atoms to see n-type semiconductor, or suppose third fifth group element, where more number of fifth group elements are adding to silicon, that is n-type semiconductor is forming. That means if you increase the more number of n-type atoms or impurities, more number of fifth group atoms are impurities, that is we are calling impurities. So conductivity increase and number of free charge carriers also increase. Similarly, p-type also, if you increase more number of third group atoms, more number of holes will increase in p-type semiconductor, so that we can increase the number of charge carriers in n-type as well as p-type by increasing the doping. So why we have to increase the doping? So more number of electrons holes will increase means we will get the more recombinations and we will get more number of photons in this process. Okay, so if you increase the doping, the Fermi level goes up. Generally, so this is goes up. Fermi level indicates the charge carrier density in a semiconductor. So this Fermi level goes up here. So this is the equilibrium condition. We will draw again this one. I am drawing again this one. Band bending diagram. So the Fermi level goes up here and Fermi level goes down in the P side. This is P side, this is N side, this is the EC and this is EV and this is EF for N side, P side. Okay, this is also EF and EC and EV. So here you can see this is the depletion region. So here more number of electrons are here because we increase the doping here. Here more number of holes available per p-type semiconductor and more number of electrons available for n-type semiconductor if you increase the doping. Now we will connect the forward bias condition to this semiconductor. So we are connecting forward bias semiconductor, forward bias condition, that is positive terminal is connecting to p-type and negative terminal is connecting to n-type. So what happens in this forward bias condition? These electrons will diffuse towards the interface. These electrons, what happens? These electrons diffuse towards the interface and also these holes diffuse towards the interface. In this process, these electrons in the conduction band and holes in the valence band. So these electrons jump from conduction band to valence band. These electrons jumps from conduction band to valence band and they will recombine with holes in the valence band. This is the what we are calling recombination of electron hole pairs. Okay. Once electron will recombine with holes, they will emit energy as a photons. They will emit excess energy in the form of photons. That is what we need in the LED. Okay, LED means light is emitting, just light emitting device. Okay, here also photons is nothing but that is light only. Okay, light only. So this is the how photons are emitting in a LED, or you can say this is working principle of LED. Now see, so here what type of thing is, what type of materials we have take for, we have to consider for construction of LED or to fabricate the LED device. So we know direct band gap semiconductor emits the photons, indirect band gap semiconductor emits the photons. So we need photons. So we have to consider the direct band gap semiconductor for light emitting diodes. Okay, what are the mainly silicon germanium, these are the indirect band gap semiconductor, mainly compound semiconductor, that is third compound semiconductor like second fourth group or third fifth or fourth sixth group elements are generally compound. We are calling these are compound semiconductor. Here like example ZnS and here gallium arsenide or gallium arsenide phosphide or here silicon carbide. These are the compound semiconductor. These are direct band gap semiconductor. So if you use this third fifth group elements, we can get the photon using this semiconductor. So now suppose if you take, so this is the third materials we are considering like third group elements or fifth group, mostly third fifth are using for LEDs. These LEDs also, the depending on our requirement, that is emitted photon color or wavelength. Suppose if you want to if you want red color photons or if you want blue color photons, you have to choose accordingly your material. Okay, the emitted photon wavelength will depending on band gap of this materials or material. Okay, now see, suppose how you will estimate the emitted photon wavelength. We know formula, that is E is equal or E2 minus E1 is equal Hc by lambda, right? So Hc by lambda. Lambda is equal to here Hc by Eg, or Eg you can write. Eg. So here HC is 1240, and if you take gallium arsenide phosphide, this band gap is 1.9 electron volts. Gallium arsenide phosphide. Okay, 1.49. So if you multiply divide with 1.9, you will get electron volts. This is you will get around 650, around 650 or 640 nanometers. That means that is red color. If you use gallium arsenide, you will get the red color photons. Suppose if you want to use the blue color, accordingly you have to choose the material. That is like, suppose if you take here the material having 3 electron volts or 3.5 electron volts, you will get the wavelength of 430 nanometer. 430 nanometer means that is blue color light. Okay, depending on our requirement, we have to choose the material. That is the choosing of material. Now we will see the construction of LED. What is the construction of LED? Okay. So, construction of LED. So, here very simple construction. So, first there is a N-type semiconductor. N-type semiconductor. After that, they will make a P-type semiconductor. N-type and P-type. Already we have discussed it. It is a simple P-N junction diode. Okay. It is here by, we will take N-type material. N-type material, there is a many different techniques, many several techniques to fabricate these devices. N-type and P-type. After that, there is a dielectric layer. This is some dielectric layer. After that, there is a metal grids. Here also some metal coating is there. This is, we are calling a LED structure. With this voltage, with this contacts, these are some metal contacts, silver or some requirement, depending on our requirement. We can change the contacts material. So, here we are giving some positive voltage, positive bias. And here electrons also recombining at the interface. And these are, we are collecting, the photons are emitting. The photons are emitting through the semiconductors. Just N-type semiconductor, after that very thin P-type semiconductor. And then we are applying some, we are taking some metal contacts or depositing some metal contacts and applying positive forward bias condition, and photons are emitting. The working already we have discussed. So now see here, generally we will see construction is like this. Okay? Like this we will have here a negative positive plates are there. Negative contacts. Okay, like this. And here we will connect the LED. Okay, here we will connect the LED material. Okay, this is some glass coating. And here also there is interface. Some coatings are there. Resistive coatings to prove the shock proofs. And this is some, we will coat the some epoxy layer. What is, why we are using epoxy layer, we will explain. Epoxy layer coating. So suppose here light is emitting, right? Here from photon, from LED, photons are emitting. Suppose here incident light, it is greater than critical angle, this will reflect back. The light more than critical angle, this will reflect back. So that means the light is wasting within the material. So light should, whatever emitted light should come out from the LED. For that we are choosing the this epoxy layer. The refractive index of this epoxy layer is between air medium and in between air and semiconductor LED, semiconductor medium. That is refractive index we will take in between the semiconductor and air medium. That is why we are taking, we are putting the epoxy layer. Now we will see just one characteristics of semiconductor, this one. So IV characteristics. So here see, if you draw IV characteristics of a LED, so this is voltage axis and this is current. So if you increase the positive voltage here, positive voltage, so the current will here very slow. After some time this will start like this. So this is the IV characteristics of LED, light emitting diode. So this is some threshold voltage, or you can say any voltage. At this voltage only, beyond this voltage only, current flows in a semiconductor. Why? Because up to here we will observe very very small current in this region. Why? Because see here, once the junction is formed, here electrons, they are seeing some potential or some potential height or some potential barrier. So they want to climb this barrier, but they don't have sufficient energy. So that we are giving in forward bias condition, we are applying some energy to these electrons as well as holes, so that they are climbing some barrier or they are moving forward to the depletion region, and they will, in the depletion they will recombine. Okay, they will recombine, and we are, photons are emitting in this LED. So that up to here we will observe very very small current. After that more number of photons will diffuse to the interface and we will get the more number of more current in the LED. So this is the IV characteristics. Okay, you can draw like this. So this is the LED working and construction of the LED. Mainly this is the PN junction diode. It converts electrical energy into optical energy, and here once electrons from conduction band to valence band they will jump and they will recombine. In this recombination process they will emit the photons. So your materials to when the photons emitted photon wavelength will be chosen by material band gap. Okay, here we will mainly take compound semiconductors. Okay, thank you for, we will discuss and thank you for this one. Okay.